as well as two team bronzes, 2020, 2016 and 2022. Now, just on that head-to-head, Du Hoi Kem won their last meeting. That was a couple years ago, the Asian Cup. Prior to that, it was three straight wins for Zheng Yijing. So who knows? Listen, in the previous matchup, Jin Siyu had won the last five. Didn't make any difference, did it? Including a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, they're pretty even. You know, it's just about performance. Although I still think Zheng Yijing is much better in those close, like when it's 9-9 at the end,
right.
She's able to pull it out. But the strategy, the mental strategy, is for Zheng Yijing to try to get a big lead, to win some important points. Get Du Hoi Kem out of her element.
Yeah.
And then she makes her own job a little easier.
She started pretty well here, Zheng Yijing. What about for Du Hoi Kem? What's her strategy?
You know, I think Du Hoi Kem, it's all about confidence building. So she needs to win some big points. Like, she needs to make some good shots that she feels good about. And she needs to take away a little bit of Zheng Yijing's attack.
Right.
Du Hoi Kem, remember we said she's all about consistency. She's going to play these long rallies. She used to win a bunch of these long rallies. She'll feel good about her game.
Deep shot there from Zheng Yijing. Both these players with fine wins earlier today. Zheng Yijing now leading by four. She seems in full control at the moment, doesn't she, Zheng Yijing?
Yeah, that's what she wants. She's coming out, attacking really hard, not letting Du Hoi Kem kind of extend the rally. Not even giving Du Hoi Kem an opportunity to counterattack. Good placement there. That was a nice attack by Du Hoi Kem. We see more of that. Yeah, there we go. More pressure.
Yeah. Good work from Du. Excellent from Zheng Yijing. She's getting a little bit louder on the Chinese Taipei side. Not much.
They're very reserved, or very stoic, I would say.
I just wonder whether sometimes it's good to let yourself go a little bit more, especially when the opposition are very loud. We saw that Du was really good at placement, wasn't she, in her earlier match?
Yeah, she is. And that's one of her key strategies, extend the rallies. But in order to keep the rally going, she has to place the ball very well. Zheng Yijing saying, oh, man.
Couple of good points here for Du Hoi Kem as she's trying to hunt down this deficit.
Jing Jing not pleased with herself for that point. She's like, oh, a little head scratch. She's telling herself, refocus.
Yeah.
Play like I did a little earlier before the string of points. Be more aggressive.
That was real intensity there from Du Hoi Kam.
It was, and you see Jing Jing now being the one on the defense, right? Allowing Du Hoi Kam to attack. The tides have turned.
7-8.
Now, you really don't want to do that against Du Hoi Kam. It's her game. Du Hoi Kam wants you to kind of give her some soft balls into the rally, and she'll finish it.
Yeah, it's important there for Jung Yi-Ching just to break that run of Du Hoi Kam's three in a row.
And she's very good in the end game, Jung Yi-Ching. So it's time to bring out all that experience. Perfect play. Great setup, served long, quite daring, and then kept the pressure on. She knew she had to earn that.
There you go. There's a reaction from Jung Yi-Ching. Three game points now for her. Good winner to bring up the game for Jung Yi-Ching. Chinese Taipei needing to win this match to stay alive.
Du Hoi Kam coming out kind of guns blazing, much more aggressive, keeping the pressure on. That's what was working in that middle end of the game before for Du Hoi Kam, just to maintain that throughout an entire game.
One block.
What a rally. Jing Jing from far behind the table, closer to the table. And it was very technical too. The placement, extremely calculated.
Went short, then long. Good work from Jing Jing. On the serve, interesting, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was a very interesting serve. It looked like it was long, but it was kind of slow, like the pace was different.
Yeah, she might have just misread that on Du Hoi Kam, and 6-2 now. Jung Yi-Ching, momentum clearly back in her favor.
You know, in the beginning of each of the games, Jing Jing is not that impressive in a way. It's always kind of close, but at the end, she can really hold her own.
Just took some pace off that one. Du Hoi Kam.
Yeah. She really had Jing Jing pegged with that shot into the middle. Du Hoi Kam is so good at hitting into his opponent's middle, forcing them to move. So a lot of players get stuck kind of making awkward shots from the middle.
A
lot of the head from the coach. You're doing well. To Du Hoi Kam.
I'm thinking about Jing Jing's match play. It's like she just needs to keep it close until the end, and then she pulls away. That's what she's going to look to do here.
Fantastic. Wow. From Jing Yi-Ching.
just beautiful. And there's Dzindzachi, their coach. Looking just minorly pleased.
Again, it's very different reactions.
Like, got the job done. Nice work. Duhoy Kim, if she plays aggressively, you know, she has a real chance to win every point.
Well, she will take that. A little apology from Duhoy Kim, but. Just off the top of the net. Looking good here for Duhoy Kim. Up by three. Now she looks to pull this back.
Wow.
Well, she started slow there, Zheng Yiqing, tried to quicken the pace. Duhoy Kim was equal to the task.
Yeah, this is tricky because Duhoy Kim is so good at just keeping the rally going. And Duhoy Kim's placement into the middle is just so good.
It just shows the domination at the moment from Duhoy Kim, illustrated by the fact that she's won 7 of the last 8 points. There's problems here for Zheng Yiqing.
I'm just so impressed with Duhoy Kim's placement. Like, every ball is placed in a way that just disarms Zheng Yiqing.
She seems to have really lost her way, Zheng Yiqing. Is that just a little glimmer of hope for her?
Mm-hmm. She's very good at end game, so this is the end. It's time to turn it on, as she has every time before.
That backhand right to that corner.
I feel that Zheng Yiqing is turning it on.
Is there enough time, though? And she doesn't want to let this one fester. Zheng Yiqing to get any closer.
And it's also like a confidence pickup. She takes her timeouts quite early. As soon as the other player makes a small string, just 2 points in a row, the coach knows it's time. It's time to give Duhoy Kim that pep talk.
It worked before, didn't it?
It did in that first match.
Well, it certainly worked here again for Duhoy Kim.
10-7.
3 game points for the Hong Konger. Yeah, nothing she could do about that one, too.
Yeah. Good point for Zheng Yiqing to pick up. And now she has to show her experience. She's down. She really wants this game. If she wins this game, Zheng Yiqing, I think
that's going to be a huge boost for her.
And a huge confidence crusher for Duhoy Kim.
Yeah.
So could really determine how the next couple games go. Whoa.
Fantastic, Zheng Yiqing.
Great prediction. And even the Chinese Taipei team on their feet.
A few of them.
A few of them.
Eight, nine.
Well, she wins at Du Hoi Kem. Yeah, that momentum you just feel in Du Hoi Kem's favour. She's playing just a great range of shots at the moment, Du Hoi Kem. Adjustment from both players. Oh, she was in trouble, wasn't she, though? Zheng Yiqing.
I think I need a breather after that point.
I think they do, too.
So, rescues that net, runs in. This reaction time is incredible. Look at Zheng Yiqing, she's almost on the ground. Du Hoi Kem pulling out that last game, making it 1-1. I think it's so even here. Scoreline couldn't be closer.
Yeah, scoreline certainly is close, but you just feel, and I'm just going on the noise factor alone, that Hong Kong, they feel they're on top.
They're bringing all of the energy. I mean, they are leading.
They are leading, you're right. It's 2-1 in the tie.
You know, they're the underdogs in this match, but not by much.
Yeah, Du Hoi Kem takes this 2-1. That's real pressure on Zheng Yiqing.
Du Hoi Kem playing incredible. If she continues on like this, she has a chance of winning this entire tie.
I mean, this is giving her a big boost, isn't it? These kind of rallies that she's coming out on top on.
Now, she's mentioned in some of her previous interviews difficulties with confidence, but I think today she's full of confidence. She's playing incredible. Great placement, really targeting Zheng Yiqing's middle.
And for Zheng Yiqing, it's not working out. She's sort of, it's like sunken shoulders, unforced errors creeping up.
Yeah. Sort of losing her footing. This sometimes happens and you're like, what's going on?
Very useful 3-point lead here for Du Hoi Kem. It's all going nicely for the Hong Kong player.
Yeah, Zheng Yiqing usually can make some of those shots, right? So I think she's feeling the pressure, feeling the nerves.
Look at that, Du Hoi Kem dominant again. Six of the last eight in her favor. Yeah, you know when the player raises both hands, that's real frustration. It's almost like I can't do anything right now.
Right, like
nothing's going my way.
Universe is not on my side.
Right. Well, sometimes you need that little slice of luck, right?
And the universe says, hold on, let me toss you one.
Let me balance it out a little bit.
Is it enough?
better here for Zheng Yijing.
Comeback is coming.
All of a sudden, it has just gone the other way.
Is the comeback gonna come too late? Let's see.
Yeah, my feet might be that way.
Seven, nine.
Still in this, Zheng Yijing.
Never say never. And this is just the third game. So it could go either way, but it really puts pressure on the person who loses this.
Seven, ten.
Three game points to Hoikem.
That meant a lot. Stopping that comeback. Trying to finish it off, Duhuikim here.
Absolutely huge for Duhuikim.
And she has an opportunity to get a medal for Hong Kong, China. So they're quarterfinals. Winners guaranteed a medal.
That's a really good point, Barbara, because anyone who wins this automatically gets that medal. That's so important to remember. Chinese Taipei did it last time out. Hong Kong missed out. But look, Zheng Yijing is an experienced campaigner. This is where that will come to the fore.
Mm-hmm. And that's where the experience comes in. She has likely been in the situation before, has needed to come back from behind. And she's coming out in this game very measured, very careful in a way. Her wits are about her.
Do I get, we'll have that momentum. She looks puzzled, Zheng Yijing.
Oh.
Most things are going Zhu Hoikem's way at the moment, aren't they?
The universe is conspiring, but also a great rally from both players.
Good.
I lost count how many shots there were at this breakneck speed.
Not happy.
Not.
Zheng Yijing, and she asked for a timeout.
Kind of, or sorry, don't counter loop so frequently. Sometimes you can block, because when you counter loop, Duhui Kim is using your own spin against you. There she goes, just blocking. Don't counter loop.
It's great when the advice works out.
It really is.
So the block presumably just sends back exactly what you just received, right?
Right, you're not adding more spin.
Right.
Usually you want to add more spin, but this time Du Hoi Kim is just using it against you. Listen to Hong Kong China on the bench.
Every point is like that, isn't it? Great shot.
Oh. That face from Du Hoi Kim after that net didn't go over reminds me of that emoji where all the teeth are showing. Just like, ugh.
Better from Zheng Yuqing. Just got a little noisier in here.
I'm feeling extra tense. This is very close and very meaningful.
Just in front here. Puff of the cheeks from Zheng Yuqing.
Timeouts are both used. No more opportunities.
You think now would have been a timeout time if they could?
I think somebody would use one. In the next couple points, someone will use one. But no opportunity. On your own. Good work.
Well, you talked about Zheng Yuqing and her experience. Particularly towards the end of games. This would be a good time as any now to use all of that experience you mentioned.
Coming from behind, she's down. She has to win this game. And now the universe a little bit on Zheng Yuqing's side.
What a time to do it.
This is a big one.
Important for Du Hoi Kim to draw level there.
So fast. Zheng Yuqing maybe thinking, oh, why did I add spin on my forehand again? I should have blocked.
As I was told to. Mm-hmm.
It worked a little bit ago. Very nice serve.
Just a point at a time now at these two. Chinese Taipei, you can sense they're also now feeling it.
That doesn't feel good for Zheng Yuqing. If Du Hoi Kim can pull this out, this would be quite the upset. And a guaranteed medal.
Yeah, it would be. Absolutely right. Interesting there from Du Hoi Kim. It's Zheng Yuqing now in front.
This is Zheng Yuqing's experience playing through. I mean, they're both very experienced, so to be a top 10 player, you have to get really good at this type of end game.
massive for Zheng Yijing.
And that scream from the bench. Not much emotion for Zheng Yijing.
Two game points for Zheng Yijing to make it 2-2.
That is that end game mental strength.
Let's see how Du Hui Kim now copes with the pressure on her end for once.
Who is the most tournament tough?
Well, it's Zheng Yijing who comes out on top.
By looking at the first part of the game.
Yeah.
One long.
Reminder again that if Du Hui Kim wins it, then this tie is done. If Zheng Yijing wins it, we are going into a fifth and final match. It's a good start here, Zheng Yijing.
2 points on the serve. See Du Hui Kim taking her time. She went and picked up her own ball.
Finally, that Taiwan, that Chinese Taipei bench has come alive. I guess
love to see it.
They're saving it for the for when it matters. Mm.
There's only so much in the tank.
Great start here, though, for Zheng Yijing, Chinese Taipei.
The Chinese Taipei team knows that they need to get this early lead. And that gives them a great mental advantage against Du Hui Kim.
Well, someone's really letting loose there.
Now
and all that control, Barbara, sorry, mm-hmm. from Du Hui Kim just seems to have gone.
Mm-hmm. We're going to watch Du Hui Kim to see if she can fight back. She brings that spirit again. The match is actually quite even.
This is fantastic for Zheng Yijing. What a start here. Du Hui Kim. If there was a timeout, you'd have thought she'd have taken it by now just to stem the tide. But she's in real trouble.
Yeah. Five love.
Du Hui Kim is not a player that plays the best from behind. Now she likes to keep that confidence going from the beginning. So we'll see if she can change things up here.
1-5.
She needs a big run of points here, Du Hui Kim. Reminder, we've got a men's quarterfinal after this here on this table. France against Portugal.
That body language from Du Hui Kim says, I think Zheng Yijing might have this in the bag.
Yeah, I agree with you. Look how it shifted dramatically to Zheng Yijing. 20 of the last 32 points have gone her way. Wow, this is one-way traffic at the moment.
Yeah. Du Hui Kim lost some of that confidence as soon as they started that fifth game.
Nice
one. You know, to me, this is basically in the bag for Zheng Yijing. Never say never, but Du Hui Kim not looking as loose.
I guess she was saving herself up, wasn't she, Zheng Yijing?
She's great end game, Zheng Yijing.
She's just kind of all over the place at the moment, Du Hui Kim.
Yeah, I think she knows.
Yeah.
She knows. This is a big mountain.
Yeah, it's muted, isn't it? That's the quietest we've heard Hong Kong celebrate a point. They know it too, because it would need something very special from here, from Du Hoi Kem.
And she's not a player that plays the best from behind.
The belief will start coming when she gets maybe about three or four more points. Mm-hmm.
But it might be a little late.
Yeah. Yeah, she needs something pretty, pretty special.
You know, live, we can see Chen Xu kind of warming up, stretching.
And look at that, 7 match points now for Zheng Yijing.
And this game has gone exceptionally quickly.
Yeah, definitely the quickest one for sure. So Zheng Yijing uses all that experience. Look at that.